people often ask me, well, quite a lot of stuff about my setup because it's very simple. It's a pod and a guitar. And there's a lot of reasons why I do it that way compared to lugging around a huge amp, like a quad box or even a 212, for example. You know, there's nothing wrong with that. And you know, great amp tone's great amp tone, but it's hard to get at every gig because you're relying on so many other variables, like what kind of mic, the mic placement, the front of house engineer, the PA, the room. There's a lot of stuff that can have an impact on your overall sound. Another thing that I learnt sort of along the way is the less stage noise that you have, the better it sounds at the front. So I know some guitarists can be quite proud and attached to their setup, which is fine and understandable, but I think it can also sometimes be to the detriment of the punter's experience. And at the end of the day, who are you playing for? Like yourself on stage or the people who have come to see you and probably paid money. So from my point of view, I wanted to create the best experience possible for the people who come to watch the band and also make my life easier. I can tour internationally. I've got a road case. That's it. I can carry my entire rig in one trip from the car. So that's awesome. Compared to the old days, I used to be, you know, lugging around heaps of gear because I thought that's what you had to do. To anyone watching this who's in the process of searching for the ideal setup, I can say from my experience is that the pod, the Variax, and as if you've got the luxury of having your own L2s, then, you know, that's good. I personally use the L2s in the studio and I find it really good for creating tones. You need to have good referencing to know how it's going to sound front of house. So I can hear what other people are going to hear when I get to the gig. That makes the job easier for the front of house guy. It means my tone's going to be more consistent, and also I'm representing myself how I want to be represented. And the only thing I can be disappointed about is if I screw up, you know, it's not my tone, you know, that's the thing that I don't want to let me down. So in summary, I think the full range setup is for me for a number of reasons. It's efficient, it's light, you know, it's very versatile, and you know, I dig it. So check it out if you can.